Well, there's somebody asked about two issues. One is what should we be measuring? And I agree with you completely. The problem of what to measure makes these aging type statements, you know, what does it mean to say we'll control most of them? And what does control mean, even? And, you know, Siebens knows that and writes about that in his papers. And one thing you didn't mention that complicates it even more is we don't know very much about failed invasions. And species that get there, don't spread, and sometimes disappear. How can we improve on that? We'd obviously need much more monitoring. And it maybe wouldn't have to be monitoring everything, but monitoring in a way that would, we could have indicators of some sorts, you know, of different taxa. And I think in an age, especially of cell phones and an increasingly educated population, the person power problem, which has always stymied the whole idea of monitoring, could at least partially be solved. So that's sort of my statement about measurement of what we could measure. You know, how many populations really arrive, and then and how many arrive and don't, and which species disappear. As for whether we should give up in the face of the apparent failure so far, I would say no. There are a number of local successes. I didn't talk about eradications, and I could have. You know, some of them are legendary. The ones of Calypa taxifolia, the Kilmer alga would be a good example, and the Caribbean black striped mussel in Australia. It required acting very quickly and having the resources to do it. And these are almost really that expensive. So there are a number of successes, and as I said at the end that I didn't give any details, I could give lecture after lecture on promising new approaches or new ways of implementing older approaches, all of which are incremental. And I think it's possible that some of the genetic-based new technologies might be very useful in some settings. So I would say, hell no, don't give up.